것까지.
아니, 새로 빠른 전멸 추적차일 수도 있고요.
아, 그런가요? 지금 암흑청소가 지금, 암흑청소 생각한다면 지금 타면 올라갔을 텐데.
예.
자, 관문을 늘려주고 있어요.
예, 그렇죠.
암흑청소 올라가세요.
네. 전멸 추적차를 생각했다면 저 정도 빠른 타이밍에 황혼 의예를 올릴 그렇죠. 필요가 네. 없습니다. 그렇기 때문에 암흑청소를 준비해주고 있고요.
자, 이거 모르면 그냥. 그냥 한 방에, 그냥 한 방에 게임 끝날 수 있어요, 분명히.
예, 그렇죠. 하지만 지금 예, 번식시 네. 타이밍이 그렇게 늦지는 않다는 것. 사실 박성준 선수가 평소에 프로토스 전을 할 때 저글링의 스피드 업그레이드 이후에 바로 번식시 업그레이드. 네. 어떤 다른 저글들보다 번식시 업그레이드가 좀 빠른 편이에요.
네.
그렇기 때문에 이거 어쨌든 의도만 파악한다면 충분히 막아낼 수 있는 네. 번식시 타이밍이네요.
일단 앞마당을 가져가는 척 하면서 파수기와 함께 내려와서 승격력이 내려오는 그런 액션을 일단 취해주고 있고요.
그렇죠.
자, 대구를 들어가 보나요? 네. 이거 쑥 들어가 보면은 먼길 왔어요. 그런 시간을 주게 되는 거죠.
그렇죠.
먼길 왔습니다. 일단 앞마당까지 가져갑니다. 그러면서 또.
그러면서 파수기 경기까지 보여줬어요.
경력 생산을 진짜 거의 안 하고 있어요. 이번에 바람 저글링 맹독 죽였으면 그냥 게임 완전히 끝나는 거였고 저글링만 좀 많이 만들었는데
이거
깊이 아직 못 봤어요.
이거 아쉬운데요. 이거 한 2초 정도만 좀 조금만 더 들어갔다면
앞마당 보고 그냥 뺐죠.
그렇죠.
자 지금
사실 경력이 굉장히 적은 최영화 선수의 상황이었거든요.
지금 지금 어디서 만들고 있죠? 본진 쪽인가요? 아니면은 그래 본진 쪽이 만들고 있네요.
이제 이 나와 있는 거 이거 완벽하게 파악을 하고 있는 건데요.
기사 이렇게 되면 글쎄요 조금 허무하게 잡힐 수도 있는 상황인데요. 자 이미 데뷔를 해놓고 있는 박동훈 선수로 다시 토크까지 상대가 뭔가 이상하다 이거죠 지금.
이거 정면 쪽으로
못 들어가요 앞길 막고 있어.
자 갑쳤고 여기서 세이브 다 잡히면 이거 너무 큰데요. 예. 이렇게 되면 빠른 앞마당까지 가져갔기 때문에 뷰탈리스크 타이밍에 프로토스가 굉장히 취약할 수가 있습니다.
걸렸고요. 그렇죠. 암흑기사가 지금 어디서 왔나 충분히 예측할 수 있는 그런 수정상 있고 최영호 선수는 앞마당을 가져가는 페이크였거든요. 일단은 가져가고 싶었던 상황이 아니고 페이크였었단 말이에요.
예.
변신수까지.
변신수로 상대 병력 움직임, 병력 숫자 완벽하게 네. 파악하면 이거 뷰탈리스크 6-7 대로 뽑을 수 있어요.
네.
예.
정말 잘 숨어있네요, 이거.
같이 움직여야 됩니다.
쑥 들어가서 세일 네. 다 확인하죠.
네.
야, 박성우 선수 정신없는 꽁꽁한 플레이 굉장히 잘해주고 있어요.
네, 이거 전혀 모르고 있어요, 최영화 선수.
가봤어요.
것까지 다 확인했고요.
자기 알려드리고.
박성준 선수에서 주특기가 충분히 나올 수 있는 상황이네요.
이번 주 신경 써야 되는 게 많아지는 최영화 선수란 말씀이시죠. 맞습니다. 과연 떴어요. 뷰탈리스크 이미 떴습니다.
일단 추가 멀티는 암흑기사로 교체를 해서 여기를 취소해야 될 것 같고요. 감시구지가 뭐 그쵸 있다 할지라도 병력들이 다 다른 곳에 있기 때문에
예. 취소한다 생각하고 하지만 뷰탈리스크가 저글링으로 앞마당을 한 번에 뚫어버리겠다 이런 생각으로
자 일단 저글링으로
저글링이 지금
취소한 것 같은데요.
예.
뷰탈리스크
약간 무리했는데
이쪽도 불어왔죠. 대응이 굉장히 빠릅니다.
네, 앞마당이 가깝습니다. 앞마당에 가까워서 뷰탈리스크 활약할 기회도 많아요 지금. 앞마당에 가까워서
예, 이거 네. 근데 건물 CMCT가 이거 역적인데요.
그렇죠. 자, 한기 가지만 틈을 비집고 들어가서
스 다 조절하면서 타이밍 잡고 러시가 생각하고 있는데 박성준 선수 만약에 지금 1벌레 타이밍 잡았으면 굉장히 힘들어질 수도 있어요.
저글링 계산해 주고요. 저글링 16기쯤 보낼 수 있어요.
네. 저글링과 뷰탈리스크를 동시에 찍었습니다. 그러면서 지금 일단
광전사와 가스가 많이 없기 때문에 광전사 위주로 병력을 생산하고 있는데요.
예.
이렇게 되면 뷰탈리스크와 저글링 다시 촉수로 수족자만 어떻게든 좀
파악하려고 이거 너무 성급하게 갔네요.
너무 성급해요. 같이 싸워야 되거든요. 박성준 저글링 갔었어요.
저글링 갔었어요. 수족자를 가두는
전면. 진짜 많이 살아남았죠. 지금 이제 뮤탈리스가 와서 시간을 벌고 있는데 이것만 막으면 박성준 선수 이것만 막으면 되고 최영화 선수 지금 어떻게든 풀어야 돼요. 자, 알기 때문에 지금 수정탑을 파괴하는 박성준 선수인데 파괴가 되지 않았고요. 들어갑니다. 수정탑
예, 많아요. 다른 일 뽑을 필요 없이 뮤탈리스가 정리만 뽑아내고 막아야 돼요. 뒤쪽에 부탄 어디 가나요? 왜 이렇게 늦나요?
어떻게 나요?
정리를 못 알아보게 욕자 굉장히 잘 쳐줬고요.
박수가 나오기 시작하긴 하는데 막나요.
예, 이거 충분히 막을 것 같아요.
박기와 정리 뷰탈리스크 방어한대 소설체
Tasteless Prime vs. Star Tail. It is the second match of the night.
We've already had three great hours of action.
Yep.
Maybe it's time to breathe more.
Cannot wait. Head to head here. Star Teal and Prime.
Star Aqua. Aquamarine.
We got two very talented teams. Star Teal made it to the finals in what was a very close series.
She's getting some delicious cocoa. I couldn't ask you there. Here we have Star Teal on the right, Prime on the left. Bunch of sick ballers on both sides. Prime certainly has increased standing since last season, where they way underperformed. But is it up to Star Tail's level? That, Tasteless,
is the question
of the hour.
Well, Star Teal is a team that has big names from StarCraft 1, such as July Zerg, yep, such as Rainbow. Prime, most of the players not as well known as StarCraft 1.
Yeah, no, a lot of Warcraft 3 players on Prime. Definitely has a strong Warcraft 3 foundation.
Yep.
They also have a stuffed animal.
No, that's I think it's a mushroom.
Extra life. It's a one-up.
It's a one-up mushroom.
Oh, excellent.
So we can see who's the extra life here. Prime Clan.
Star Teal.
Now, I have no idea who they're going to pick for the first player at Prime. Prime, I think their best player they have is Marine King.
Yeah. Any Pro has done really well lately.
Yeah, Hongen as well.
Yeah, Hongen's done pretty well overall in the GSL. Cole has improved a lot lately, which just surprises the heck out of me, Tasteless. Let's take a look at our Prime players. Hannibal. Oh, we haven't seen him forever. That's so exciting. Check. Holt.
Marine King.
Maka.
Hongen. Don't forget about Hongen.
Any pro.
And
Bong Bong. The Bong Bong.
And
I want to see Bong Bong versus Hyperdub.
So as you can see, they actually have quite some big contenders here. Hongen, Anypro, Check, Bolt, and Marine King all in Code S. I actually didn't realize there were that many Prime guys in Code S.
I know, they're a little sneaky like that. They've all been kind of quiet except Anypro in the last season,
yeah.
So we tend to forget about them. A lot of them were in Up and Down, but they've done pretty well overall, actually.
Now, what's funny is that nobody's in Code A. Normally you have at least,
Yeah, you have someone in Code A.
Some Code A people or some Code S people.
Prime is all or nothing.
Yeah. It's going to be interesting to see the series of events here, who they're going to pick first. Do you have any predictions, Artosis?
For the first player?
Could it be Check?
Yeah, that would be a good
idea. I would not be shocked if it was Check.
I agree with you completely, actually. I think that would be a great choice to put out Check first.
Now on to our other team over here. Star Teal. This team, pretty intimidating. Got a lot of tough players. And, of course, July Zerg, I think, probably the most well-known. Let's take a look. Rainbow. Control.
Ooh.
July. Virus. Squirtle. He all killed in the previous season. Bomber. A lot of people are afraid of him. Curious. Ace.
And the head coach.
Oh, yeah. And that is Star Teal. Now, remember Bomber? Everybody was talking about him in the previous team league.
Yeah.
Because he was just so sick.
And he had that sick game with MVP as well.
That was one of the best TVGs I've seen.
July, Rainbow, and Virus in Code S. August and Ace in Code A. Very excited about this match.
Yeah, I cannot wait, man. It's going to be so cool. So many good players, actually, on both sides that we won't get to even see because,
I do want to point out that we saw Hannibal on the roster, and a lot of you probably were like, why is Artosis going crazy about Hannibal? Well, let me take you back to a time before StarCraft II's release, a time called the Beta. And basically, there was two main followings of people who like Terran in Korea. The ones who thought Maka was the best, and the ones who thought Hannibal was the best. Now, the ones that thought Maka were the best were the ones that were right. But the guys who liked Hannibal He was like a banshee guy. He was like a, I do complex all-ins. You know, I do a lot of tech on one base, and, you know, I'm going to do, like, banshees and a hellion drop and all this, that, the other thing. Whereas Mako was more of kind of like a macro Terran. So a lot of people in Korea actually thought, you know what, Hannibal is the best Terran in the beta.
Mako sort of, you know, outdid him there. But
yeah, and Snare actually did too towards the end.
Yeah, and Snare
those three
too.
Definitely like, the best Terrans in the
don't
beta.
Don't leave Snare out. But Mako, you know, lately Mako has been having a hard time.
He has. He's out of Code A.
Yeah.
But Hannibal, since he fell away towards the end of the beta, has been non-existent. We haven't seen him anywhere. He hasn't done anything. But he's on the roster, so he must have been improving.
Yeah, I mean, they're bringing him out here today. We don't always have every single player from the team out there.
Maybe they finally put elephants into the game.
Ooh. Wait, what?
His name is Hannibal, man.
Oh, okay. Sorry, guys. I dropped the ball on that joke. So, I don't know who they were going to pick. Our guess is going to be it's going to be Check in there. What do you think it will be for Star Trek?
Check is a great choice.
What about Rainbow?
I thought you'd say that, but I don't know. I don't care for putting Rainbow out here. I think that StarTail is a better lineup.
Maybe
he's in Code S.
He might have Bomber, actually.
Bomber first? Ooh, that would be interesting.
That would be very
it?
Interesting.
That might. Maybe.
All right. It's going to be Polt.
Putting Polt out first. All right. I'll roll with it.
We'll
see where you're going,
Brian.
Yeah, he's playing really well recently, which is quite surprising because he was falling off the map and fast.
Yeah, man. I mean, he was one basing hardcore.
Two basing hardcore. Third command center never existed. It's like, but nowadays,
it's like watching a Warcraft 3 game, man.
Yeah.
Polt, you're on camera. Polt is going to go ahead go get those headphones on. He is a Terran player. He is solid. Now, to see who is going to be picked by StarTail. This is a tough pick here. Oh, my God. I'm actually right.
Yeah.
Well,
I'm not overly surprised. It's a guy that came to mind. I thought they might pick. I don't know.
I guess it makes sense. They probably made that up long before they.
Well, he's a well-rounded player.
Yeah,
and a lot of people put out someone that's not really their best first, and I think Rainbow isn't the guy you want against their best. But he's just a well-rounded, solid Terran.
I doubt Rainbow would be picked last.
Oh, certainly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly. Yeah, he's not the anchor of the team. He's like, all right, this is a really good, like, mid-range player.
Well, he's a little bit above mid-range.
Right. Yeah,
four if you were to rank everybody up on StarTail. He's had results, you know. And, I mean, you get to the semifinals twice, or finals once, semifinals, another tournament. That indicates you're going to be able to beat the average person they throw at you. So I think Rainbow's here to knock games off of Prime.
Yeah,
as many
just
as
take
can.
As many games as he can.
And then they're going to start probably assassinating. You know, getting sniper players.
Yeah, and they have good snipers in the StarTail team.
The countdown's begun. Head-to-head here. Protoss. I mean, Terran versus Terran. What am I saying? Rainbow's a Terran player now. Not like he's a circuit one. Head-to-head here. Let's see who's going to win this. I'm Tasteless with me is Artosis. This is the GSL Team League. Over here in the bottom left, in the red, a rapidly improving Terran player.
Gumio Poyu.
Polt. There he is now with Ninja Turtles 2 green glowing out of his headset. Over here in the bottom right, we have one of the most well-rounded StarCraft 2 players, also excellent at harassing.
TSA Trickster.
TSL Trickster.
Ouch. Well, we had like the most random. What? All right.
Wow.
That's Rainbow, guys, not Trickster.
Somebody is
made
get
a boo-boo. All right.
We make John put on a little mask and behead these people that make mistakes in production. We're sorry, guys.